to send asylum seekers to Rwanda. Individual asylum seekers and a charity say that Rwanda has failed to give assurances about the safety of people who'd be relocated there. Jacqueline McKenzie is a human rights lawyer and is with us now. Hi, it's great to see you. Thanks very much indeed for joining us. So what's going to happen today?
Well, the judgment will be read out in open court today based on whether the appeal will succeed, based on whether the plans to send people to Rwanda is actually unlawful or not.
Mm. And then what happens?
Well, it depends on which way it goes.
Exactly.
So, if the appeal is allowed, you know, obviously, people will be very happy, but it still begs the question as to why have we got to this position in the first place? The UK gets relatively few asylum seekers in the scheme of things, you know? I mean, the question is mostly predicated around these small boats, and we had about 45,000 people coming last year. But if you look at that in terms of what's happening globally, and the fact that there are 50 million refugees around the world, you know, there are 100 million people seeking asylum, and countries like Poland took in 2 million Ukrainians, why did we consider that the Rwanda plan was a sensible one or a suitable one in the first place? That's one of the issues. So we don't know what's going to happen, but whatever does happen, either side's going to appeal to the Supreme Court or seek leave to appeal to the Supreme Court.
And just to explain to our viewers the process of that, you know, there have been a number of defeats so far.
Yes.
Whatever is decided today, there will be a leave to, or an application for a leave to appeal.
Yes.
And then what happens?
Well, you have to wait for a date.
Yeah. But is that a process that takes weeks or months or years?
I think it's very unlikely that it will happen this year, although some lawyers have said that they expect it to happen before the end of the year. But what it means is that nobody's going to Rwanda anytime soon.